fear-mongers, and then we have the greed-meisters is what I call them. Remember, we have two vulnerabilities, both fear and greed, which leads to irrational optimism. We all know Bitcoin's in the news, right? Bitcoin is headed to $100,000 in 2018, says analysts who predicted last year's price. And again, if I was researching, I'd probably search back. Maybe he predicted it, maybe he didn't, but I'd also look at a bunch of his other predictions that probably didn't come true. Okay, they cherry pick. Then, not to be outdone, turn a single $20 bill into a massive fortune. Bitcoin is going nuclear. Playing on greed. And for $79, we'll show you how to turn that $20 into a massive fortune. $79. So imagine you have this greed and 1,000 people send them $79. How much is that? Are you math quiz? Okay, and then 2,000, 3,000 people send in money? Adds up pretty quick. Not to be outdone again, and you still have time on this one, thanks to a special event on February 19, 2018, one single Bitcoin in your portfolio could soon make you a millionaire. In fact, if you run the numbers, you'll see that Bitcoin 1 million is an actual mathematical certainty. Okay, so mark your calendars. Now, I can tell you, I don't know whether Bitcoin's going to a million, whether it's going to 100,000, whether it's going to 20,000 again. Okay, it peaked out around 20,000, it's right around 11 something right now. I don't know where it's going. It could go back down to zero for all kinds of different reasons. Bitcoin could be the RCA or the Motorola of cryptocurrency. We don't know. The first to market is not always the best. How many own RCA TVs? Nobody? Motorola cell phones? No. Okay. There are literally over 1,000 cryptocurrencies right now and more being created every single day. Bitcoin may or may not be the ultimate winner. We don't know that.
Bitcoin is a bubble.
Maybe Bitcoin is a kind of a bubble.
A dangerous speculative bubble.
That might actually be true. This is Bitcoin's multiple price rise over the past 3 years. And this is eight other famous asset bubbles 3 years before they peaked and burst. Bitcoin is creeping right up to perhaps the most famous bubble of all, tulip mania. And to be fair, it does have all the big signs of a bubble. The rapid pace of movements, a whole lot of speculation without sufficient understanding of the risks, and people who wouldn't otherwise invest are looking to get their skin in the Bitcoin game. The CBOE, CME, and NASDAQ are even planning to launch Bitcoin futures, the same move the Dutch pulled just before the tulip crash in the 1630s. For every asset bubble, it's the same story. Otherwise level-headed people drive prices for a certain asset to unexplainable highs, whether that's the price of Beanie Babies, stocks, houses, or perhaps cryptocurrency. Since its inception, the price of Bitcoin has gone up almost 50-fold. If it were to maintain that same rate of growth, its market cap would eclipse the US economy in a few years from now. That's why some experts are saying that Bitcoin's rapid and accelerating price appreciation is unsustainable. What it comes down to is the rate of return. For stocks, that's the dividend. In real estate, we're looking at rent. With bonds, that's coupons. But for Bitcoin, there's actually zero intrinsic value. It generates no income aside from an expectation of more price appreciation. So it's valuable because people think it's valuable. And even if you don't buy into the whole bubble narrative, this veteran trader says the technicals don't lie.
Bitcoin has gone parabolic, so that usually does not end well.
It's pretty hard to ignore the math. The velocity of the move does indicate Bitcoin's price has gone parabolic, and well, parabolic moves just don't last.
Yeah, in the next class, I'll show you all the past manias and how manias get created and how they end. We don't know how far they can go, though, because manias can go on for longer than we can imagine. Like the tech bubble, you know, when we had all those internet stocks that people were buying and the companies were making no money and just they went up and up, and that was for about a 3 year period, and then it bust. But it can also end in very, very abruptly and dramatic fashion. So we know Bitcoin went up to around $20,000, And then Bitcoin price drops $1,000 in 1 hour amongst escalating crackdowns. Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies tumble on government crackdown worries. Bitcoin slides 18% on crackdown fears. Look at this, one day, minus 22, minus 26, minus 38, minus 30, minus 33, in one day. Now, it did go up, plus 30% in one day sometimes too. But that's not investing, that's just pure speculating and gambling. The 10 biggest cryptocurrencies lose over $100 billion in 24 hours. So, right about here is where we got a few of our clients started calling, maybe we should buy some Bitcoin. When we had the gold running up, we had people asking to buy gold after it had the big run up, not down here. Even down here wouldn't be a good thing to buy because you're speculating. You don't know what's going to happen. And then technology, right? It's technology. Hackers have walked off with about 14% of big digital currencies. In less than a decade, hackers have stolen $1.2 billion worth of Bitcoin and rival currency Ether. It looks like crypto hacking is a $200 million annual revenue industry, and they have compromised more than 14% of the Bitcoin and Ether supply. And then I've heard people say, well, you know, people rob banks too. Well, if they rob the bank, who's responsible for that? The bank is responsible for that, right? If they take your cryptocurrency, it's like stealing cash. It's gone forever. The company is not responsible for it. So you have to be careful.